You should always have your first date in a public place. You ought to save some money for a rainy day. I wouldn't invest in crypto if I were you. Hi, I'm Miss Biggles. Today we have a special episode about giving advice. We'll learn modal verbs and phrases and how to use a softer or more forceful tone when advising people. Oh, here's my first guest. Hi, Clandestina.
Hi, Miss Biggles. I need some advice.
Oh, well then you've come to the right place.
Okay, so I really like this guy at work. And I've been giving him all these signs, but he doesn't seem to get it. What do I have to do to make it clear that I dig him?
Ooh, a crush. So tell me, how are you showing him that you like him?
Well, I put fruit on his chair. And I blink at him in Morse code. And I renamed my cat after him.
Ryan, where are you going, Brian? Ryan, we're so happy together, aren't we?
Okay, so those signs might not be clear. We use the modal verb should to express what we think the right thing to do in a situation is. You should say hello to him, and you should ask if he wants to get a coffee. We can say should not or shouldn't as the negative. You shouldn't blink at him so much. He might get creeped out.
Oh, you're so smart. Any other advice?
Yeah, you might want to change your cat's name back to the original one.
I might want to?
Yes. A gentle phrase for offering advice. You might want to change your cat's name because Brian is a weird name for a cat.
Oh, that's true. Okay, thanks, Miss Biggles, I'll do that.
Yeah, good luck.
Okay, thank you.
Another modal verb is would. I would subscribe to Brave English if I were you. If I were you is another conditional phrase. You can either put it first, if I were you, I would subscribe to Breathe English, or second, I would subscribe to Breathe English if I were you. For negative sentences, we say would not or wouldn't. If I were you, I wouldn't stop watching this video. Another neighbor. Hi, Steve.
Hey, Miss Biggles.
Come on in. So, what's on your mind?
Well, I've been a computer programmer for about 10 years. It's not a bad gig, and the pay is pretty good.
All right, so what's the issue?
I have a new passion, and I'm thinking about quitting my job to give my full attention to it.
All right, so what is this new passion?
Juggling.
Right. Well, can we see you juggle?
Yeah, yeah.
So I would keep your programmer job.
Really?
Yeah, I wouldn't quit your job.
But I love juggling.
If I were you, I would spend an hour a day after work juggling.
So if you were me, you wouldn't quit your job to pursue juggling full time?
No, but I would think of my computer job as a way to support my juggling passion.
Okay, that's good advice. Thanks, Ms. Biggles.
Anytime. Yep, keep practicing. Another way to give advice is to say, you had better, or you'd better. It's stronger, more forceful than should or would. For example, you'd better take the dog out. We often use this when there's a negative consequence if we don't do that thing. you'd better take the dog out or she will poop in the house. Or you'd better drive slower or you'll get a ticket. For negative, we say, you'd better not. You'd better not forget your wife's birthday or she will be angry. You'd better not lose your phone or you'll have to buy a new one. Another neighbor. Hi, Wendy.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Of course, come on in. So you seem nervous. Anything going on?
Oh, well, I have this addiction, I guess you would call it, and I don't know what to do about it.
Oh, well, what kind of addiction?
I'm addicted to eating paper.
Oh.
May I?
Okay. You'd better stop eating paper.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you'd better not eat paper or you'll have health problems.
But I'm addicted to eating paper.
You had better eat something else.
I love the taste of paper.
You could try eating rice cakes. They basically taste like paper. Could is another modal verb we use to offer a gentle suggestion. You could try eating more vegetables, or you could work less. Or you could eat rice cakes instead of paper.
They do taste like paper.
You could replace paper with rice cakes. They are a food, technically.
Thank you, Miss Biggles.
My pleasure. Bon appetit. We've got one more modal verb for giving advice. Ought to. You ought to send a thank you card. He ought to watch less TV. Ought to is more formal than the other modal verbs. However, many English speakers will put ought and to together and say oughta, which is quite informal. I oughta call my mom. For negative, you can say ought not. We ought not to be late for the flight. However, this is rarely used except for very formal situations. Oh, here's my next guest. Oh, hi, Brian.
Hey there, Miss Biggles.
How's it going?
Okay, I just got this situation.
Oh, tell me about it.
This girl at work, right? She's been acting funny.
How so?
Like, she leaves fruit on my chair and she like stares at me and blinks a bunch.
I see.
I don't know what to do. Should I ask her why she's doing those things?
Well, you ought to say thank you for the fruit.
I do like fruit.
And you ought to ask her to go for a drink. Maybe she likes you.
No way. Nobody acts like that when they like someone.
You would be surprised.
Well, she is kind of cute. I could ask her out.
Yeah. Oh, and one more thing. You ought not ask what her cat's name is.
What? Brian, don't go!
Just trust me.
Cool. Well, thanks for the tips.
Anytime. Well, there you have it. I hope you learned some modal verbs for giving advice. And I have a piece of advice for you. I would like this video. And you might want to write a comment below with your own piece of advice so you can practice using those modal verbs. And if I were you, I would watch more Breathe English videos. Until next time, neighbors, toodaloo!